Now we're going to look at email to case. We're going to set up the email to case. So since we are not using a firewall here, it's basically not much different. If it's behind the firewall, you have to download the email to case agent. Otherwise, you can just use the on-demand email to case. All right. So let's use the email to case. So to set up the email to case, again, you need to go to set type email to. You need to type email to case. So here it gives you, like, you know, with Salesforce you can resolve and correspond. It gives you with inquiries via email, customer response regarding or automatically associated with original case and all attachments to case reporting measures, both inbound and outbound emails. You can also use routing addresses. So we already seen auto response to rules and web to case. So let's look at now the things that are pending is email to case assignment and escalation rule. So let's get cracking on that. So first of all, you need to enable the email. In your case, you need to enable email to case, set case source to email. You can enable HTML if you want. And if without having to download, if you're not behind a network firewall, you can just enable the email to case. So two things you need to enable here are enable email to case here and enable email to case, set case source to email. These are some things you need to add, and enable on demand service. Once you do this, we are good to go. And you need to create a routing address. Like in my case, I already created a routing address. And this will be, in your case, if you have Outlook set, you can use set Outlook. So let me say, like, you know, let me delete this and set it up. It's taking some time for a refresh on that. So at the email to case settings, couple of things here. For the on-demand online email address, configure your email to case settings. It gives you, like, you know, each routing address and email address. So basically routing address and email address that you can submit cases. So based on the specific what setup to configure, choose on-demand email to case. Solely use Salesforce to convert email, whereas email to case enables you to salesforce.com and your email system to convert. So there is some additional setups involved which we'll do now. So first thing is enable email to case, as I told you. And now let's create the new route address. So now the routing name is going to be called new route, and I'm going to give my email. Accept email from all. So you can also create a task automatically. And what is the, who's the case owner? It's going to be, you can assign a default user or somebody from a queue. A queue is a set of users. You can go to setup and create a queue anytime here. Queue is nothing but a group of users. Usually you should assign it to a queue. So right now I'll assign it to myself. But what we'll do is let's create a queue for web assignments. And we'll call it like email assign queue. Sorry, we just got lost here. So let's go back to the queue creation and let's create the queue again. Yeah, it's got created. So now let's go back to our email to case. I'm going to create the routing now. Our queue has not yet got created, so we need to again go back here and create the email queue. So we're going to create a new layer queue, like right now I'm not going to give any email for it, and we need to select the objects which are assigned. And right now they have, we have a lot of objects, but we are going to use the case object. So this is the queue which will own the records from these objects. And who are the users? I'm going to give Bob Smith and myself. So queue is nothing but a list of users. Okay, so now this is created. If I go back over here to my email to case setting, I'll show the email assigned queue. Case origin, I'm going to keep it as web. Sorry, I'm going to keep it as email, okay? And case record type, we need not assign. If you want, you can keep it as inquiry or issue. You can decide, like, you know, what is the thing that comes in. So I can say issue. So now this routing has to be verified. Okay, now there is a conflict here because in my auto response, I have given this. So this to this email ID, so both cannot be same. So let me change the auto response. Let's deactivate the auto response for now. What was this auto response? It was sending whether that, you know, your data was, your case got created. Thank you. So you can add the information more. Now let's go back here and let's try to save this now. Alright, so I'll just use another email temporarily. Say gmail.com. That is because even my email address is the same, so I need to give a different one. So just say gmail.com, save this. So now Salesforce will automatically create email service address for you. Configure, you need to forward message to receive the emails. So now let's go to the Gmail system. I need to temporarily log out. I'll have to and see that email because it contains my public private email. Just so what happens here is you get the email from Salesforce like this way. It is asking you to, we are required to change your email address. So let me click on this and activate this. Now this email now is verified. So now if anybody, if you send an email to this email, so what happens typically is you will not be sending this to such a big email, okay? The email service address, if you want to send any record here, case here, then it will, you need to send it over here. Basically what will happen is you will create a smaller email ID, which will be a corporate email ID or a set of email IDs, and redirect the emails to that. That email you will expose to the outside world. It will be a small email like helpdesk.com, something, your company name. So case so I'm just going to create this and send this to this email. So let's see what happens. I send that email to that particular service address. So now if I go to cases and if I select all cases, it still take, because this we need to create a view because that gets assigned to the queue, if you remember. So let's create a new. Let's create a new list view. And it's going to pick it up. Some refresh issue here. We're going to create a new list view. Let's add a filter to this criteria. So let's select queue and we're going to select the email assigned queue. And when we add the filter, the case is not get created. Let's wait and see. Let's try to send the same thing from Gmail. So as you can see, the record got created and the description gets filled with whatever content you sent. And if there was an attachment sent with that, it would have got attached to this particular case. So that's how email to case works. So pause the video here, practice through the web to case, email to case, create cases from web, create case from email. And now we have also seen the assignment rule, how to do the assignment rule, but we'll also revisit that. So complete the practice and then we can proceed with the assignment tool.